Our next topic, that one is advanced technology. That one is previously we already understand that one is a CMS, content management system. That one is again with WordPress and Joomla. Then that one is used to develop the websites. The next, that one is advanced technology. It's about advanced technology. It's Bootstrap, JSF and Spring. Then Bootstrap, Twitter Bootstrap is the most popular front-end framework in the recent time. That one is again the creating the website with the help of the Bootstrap. It is a powerful mobile first front-end framework for faster and easier web development. It uses HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Bootstrap includes the HTML, CSS based design template for the templates for the typography, forms, buttons, tables, navigation, models, image, then cursors, then and many other, as well as the optional JavaScript plugins. These are the again a plus point with the help of Bootstrap we can use at the time of the web development. Bootstrap also gives you the ability to easily create the responsive designs. I mean, so it may be a dynamic processes. What is a responsive? That one is it's a responsive web designs. It's simply the dynamically it changes the particular theme of a. Or it may be automatically adjusts the screen or as per the device, automatically adjusts themselves to look good on the all device from the small phone to a large desktop. Okay, that is actual the responsive web design. Okay, then the Bootstrap is a history about Bootstrap. That one is developed by Mark and Jacob at the Twitter and released as an open source product in August 2011 on a GitHub. Then why use Bootstrap? Its advantage of Bootstrap, it's easy to use. Anybody with just a basic knowledge about the HTML and CSS starts using a Bootstrap. Responsive features, Bootstrap's responsive CSS adjust to phone, tablet and desktop. Then mobile first approach, that one is Bootstrap 3. Mobile first style are part of the core framework. Then browser compatibility, it's compatible with all modern browsers. Where to get a Bootstrap? Download it from the getbootstrap.com. Okay, what are the advantages? Easy to use, responsive features, mobile first approach and browser compatibility. Then next is simply the Bootstrap example. That one is simply the HTML, then it mentioning with some content, or it may be a files like bootstrap.mini.css, then jQuery.mini.js, then bootstrap.mini.js. That one is simply the, we include these three files to run the particular Bootstrap code. Then it's simply mentioning with the header, right? That one is a heading headers. Then simply it look like this when you run it. Then Bootstrap example 2, that one is simply the code snippet, follow the HTML element, there is a span section div, that one is simply the HTML elements. Then it's a keyboard input, it mentioning with the paragraph use KBD, that one is a control plus P, means a control print, that means keyboard input, use a control P to open the print dialog box. These are some points which means comes under the Bootstrap. Then Bootstrap it's about the contextual color and backgrounds. Bootstrap also have some contextual classes and some background classes like .text muted, .text primary. We will understand it with the example. That one is simply the all example and the output of that. That one is a contextual color, how exactly it reflect with the help of that function. Then particular it's a background examples, it's a bg.primary, it's a mentioning it's a simply the text is important, it's a bg.primary, that one is mentioning with the blue color, and same is with other background colors. That one is comes under the Bootstrap. Then this is end with the Bootstrap, how exact it useful. Then next technology, that one is a JSF, that one is a Java Server Faces. Then Java JSF is a simple MVC web framework that simplifies the construction of user interface for server based application using reusable UI component in the page. All the new technology, that one is definitely used to develop the website, but each and every technology have its own some advantages, right? In a particular situation it's good as compared to other. Same thing is a JSF, that one is related to a user interface. It's a application using a reusable of a UI component. JSF provide a facility to connect the UI pages with the data sources and to server side event handler. It's a JSF, which one is server side event handling process is done under the JSF. JSF specification defines a set of standard UI component, provides application programming interface for developing component. JSF enable the reuse and the extension of the existing standard of UI component. It's a consider as JSF is a it reuse the component. That one is again the plus point under the JSF. It's a benefit, reduce the efforts in creating and maintaining the application. Then web application facilities under the JSF for providing a reusable UI component, making easy data transfer between the UI component, managing UI state across the multiple server requests, enable the implementation of custom component, writing wiring client side event to server side application code. These are the some benefits under the JSF. Then JSF architecture, it's come with a, this is the diagram of a JSF architecture. It's a mobile or computer communicate with the J2E and with the application server. Then application server contains a multiple component, that one is a JSF content Java bean component, then custom tag library, then custom tag library for rendering the UI component, then UI component represent the stateful object, server side is a helper classes, is a validator, event handler, navigation handler, application configuration resource file, that one is used under the particular architecture. Then there are controller which can be used to perform the user action. This is simply the controller which one is used to perform the user action. Then UI can create by web pages or a web page author, and the business logic can be utilized by managed bin. Then next, that one is a managed bin, which one is used to execute the whatever the controller say to execute it. Okay, then again the controllers some creates some views, it's created with the JSP JSF component, and it's again reply with the mobile or a computer. Then if it is under the managed bin, that means again the accessing some data if it is needed, and again under the JSF pages it send a request to managed bin to access the particular data. That one is simply the working about the JSF architecture. Then its life cycle consists of 6 phases. It's restored the web page, apply request value phase, then the process the validations phase, then update the model value, then invoke the application and render the response phase. These are the JSF life cycle steps. Then the next technology, advanced technology, is the Spring. That one is simply the Spring was developed by Rod Johnson in 2003. Spring framework makes easy development of a Java EE application. It's a lightweight framework, can be a through the framework of a framework because of it provides supports of various frameworks such as Struts, ArborNet, EJB, JSF, Tapestry. Then these are the framework, again the Spring supports this framework, that's why framework of a framework. The framework is a border sense, can be defined as a structure where we find out solution of a various technical problem. With the help of the Spring, we can solve the different type of technical problems. Spring framework comprises several modules such as IOC, AOP, DAO, Context, ORM, Web, MVC. Then it's actual the modules related to a Spring. We will understand one by one. Test. This layer provides support of testing with a JUnit and test ng. Means simply the base is run with the test first layer. Then second, that one is a Spring Core container. Spring Core container contains a core, beans, context and expression language. This is again the support help to core container, beans and the YUML module. Then the core and beans, this module provide a input output control and dependency injection features. Context, this module supports internationalization. Expression language, it provides supports the setting, getting property values, method invocation, access collection, indexing, named. These are the facility which one is the expression language provides. Means the Spring Core container run with the core and beans, context and expression language, and then these are the actual the work of a core and bean, context and expression language. The next AOP aspects and the instrumentation. Then these are the three next layer content. That one is again the use of that. This module support the aspect oriented programming implementation. Aspects means the view. How exact the application program logic says that with the help of that view it execute. Here you can use advices or it may be a point cuts to decouple the code. The aspects module provides a support to integration with the aspect J. Then instrumentations module provides a support to class instrumentation and the class loader implementation. These are the some point that one is related to the aspect oriented programming, aspects and the instrumentation models. These are the three points and the use of that. Data access integration, this group comprises of a JDBC, ORM, OXM, JMS and the transaction module. That one is again the next layer. That one is data access and integration. That one is again definitely related to accessing the databases. That one is web. This group comprises of web, web servlet, web std and web portlet. This model provides support to create the web application. This is a web with a web servlet, portlet, strds. These are the actual the Spring framework and it's work like layer wise with the help of this Spring components. Then it's a Spring dependency injection technology. That Spring is most identified with the dependency injection. We already understand the concept about the dependency injection. That one is a one component depend on another, or maybe one component use another component. That one is a dependency. We can say that a dependency injection, that one is used. Then when writing a complex Java application, application classes should be independent. As the point of view of programming development, definitely independency should be a less as possible of other Java classes. Okay, it to increase the possibilities to reuse these classes. If we run it with a independently, definitely we reuse it that classes. If it is a dependent, then it is difficult to reuse. Then dependency injection helps in gluing these classes together and at the same time keeping them independent. These are the dependency injection. That one is actual the Spring provides. Then Spring aspect oriented programming. That one is aspect oriented programming means aspect. That one is means a view, which one is comes from the requirement from the business logic. Function that span multiple points of application are called. Cross-cutting concern, that means simply the whatever the problem comes from the business logic, we need to again cut it and create it. Or cross-cutting concerns as the conceptually separation from the application business logic. That means whatever the business logic, we need to solve it. solve that particular problem related to a business logic. There are the various common good example of aspects including logging, declarative, transactions, security, caching. These are the problem is related to a business logic. Then key unit of modularity in OOP in the class, whereas AOP the unit of modularity is the aspect. That means again the aspect oriented programming comes with a modularity. DI helps you decouple your application object from each other, while AOP helps you decouple the cross cutting concern. DI means a dependency injection, that one is reduce the dependency, that's why we can reuse the component. AOP helps to decouple the cross cutting concern, means it's again the resolve the particular problem with the help of the AOP, that is again the useful under the Spring. In Spring example, that one is simply the steps to create the Spring application. Create the class, create the XML file to provide the value, create the test class, load the Spring jar file, run the test class. This is a way to execute. These are the references. Then these are the some advanced technology to develop the websites, that means a Bootstrap, JSF, Spring.